Namaskaram, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great privilege connecting with you again on the topic of theory of happiness. I'm sure that you must have seen the rest of the videos and then got some perspectives to continue this topic for further discussion. So as you must have got an idea by now that the subject of happiness is not that simple, but requires a little more deeper understanding in order to gain control over our own response to various stimuli of life. So taking the matter forward, there are a little more complex things I want to present to you in as simpler manner as it is possible. So if you look at the evolution over a period of time, animals for example, for no reasons they seem to be quite happy, and then they carry on with the same stable kind of enthusiasm right from the time they get up in the morning and then continue their life. So we generally ignore that, saying that they are animals, so but we are human beings. You know, we have the pride to feel that we are superior to them in every respect. But in reality, if we are really superior, then obviously we must be more peaceful and happier than the rest of the creation. But it shows that over a period of time, as the science advanced, as the civilization progressed, human beings are becoming more and more miserable than they are happy. So there may be a fundamental reason that why the latest generation of human beings, with so much of advancement in science and comforts, they are not as peaceful and happy as our forefathers. Why we are not as healthy as our forefathers? So it's an important question to be answered. That means there is a steady deterioration taking place in the whole mechanism of our attitude towards life. So long time back I heard Swami Sukhabodhananda talking about a concept called ABCD. So I thought it may be a good idea to give you some perspective on that, to understand the next topic I would like to take up with you. So the human mechanism, if you really look at, we have certain beliefs, and based on the beliefs we act on various circumstances in our life. So the ABCD stands for some of these aspects. Let us start with the letter A. So A stands for the attitude. Now, as many words that we discussed in the past in English, attitude is yet another non-specific word. Every individual understands attitude in their own way. So what is basically attitude is the human beings have got a peculiar way of making choices. For example, the current situation that we are all going through, which is lockdown and staying at home, there are many people feel that this is a big punishment to them, and they have all the time miserable thoughts being processed in their mind, and they feel that this is something which should not happen in their life, and are trying to get away with it. So that means some people are feeling lonely sitting at their home, because according to their understanding is that going for a party or you know, spending time in the bar, etc., socializing is what is really life is all about. So the circumstances remaining the same, the human beings can make different choices, basically, which I spoke about it in the previous video. So when you make choices, that is basically what his attitude is all about. What Joel Barker called it as a paradigm, you know. The word paradigm really means that you have made a choice that way, right? So some people feel that, going to work and the whole day, doing something for the company is a painful exercise. But there are few people, they thoroughly enjoy what they are doing. So it is based on the choices that we have made, our attitude is decided. So some people may feel that relaxation is coming from meditation or doing yoga, for example. But some other people may think that having alcohol gives them a relaxation. So we are seeking relaxation from different means. So going forward, we will discuss in more detail what psychology calls it as a voluntary organization of your own thoughts. So how do you organize your life? So attitude is nothing but what do we think about a particular aspect in our life. So attitude really decides your belief, for example. Attitude leads to belief. That's what B stands for. So belief is nothing but we are ignorant about something and we have decided that we are going to believe that something exists this way. Like, for example, religion is a belief, right? So, since we could not figure out and experience the presence of God, we have decided that God is in a human form, and then we created a belief. So different religion will have a different belief. Few religions believe that there is some place called heaven in the sky. To go there, then you need to do certain things. So we don't realize that only when you die you can go to the heaven. And nobody is willing to die, as you could see that the coronavirus is really threatening everyone and reminding that we will die one day. So belief is an aspect that is derived from the attitude. So, for example, that when you are working in an office in an air-conditioned ambience, even without doing any physical work, you are tired. But whereas during the weekend you may go and play tennis in the hot sun, which is a lot of physical activity, and then you may not feel tired. So belief is the result of the attitude. So A leads to B and B leads to C. C stands for commitment. The belief will lead to commitment. For example, if the religious belief says that you need to get up at 5 o'clock and then you tell all these mantras, or you should go to the temple, irrespective of whatever happens, you will do that with a commitment, right? If the belief is not very strong, your commitment will not manifest. So attitude and belief are intrinsic in nature. When you say intrinsic, it really means is that people cannot see, but people can see your actions. You cannot hide yourself from actions, you see. So commitment is an expression of your belief showing up in your actions. So A stands for attitude, B stands for belief, C stands for the commitment. So, when the commitment is there, your destiny is decided based on your commitment. If you have a commitment to meditate every day, if you have got a commitment to do your yoga, if you have got a commitment to eat healthy food, you will reach your destination at the right place. So, destination, dedication, determination. You can have many positive words in the dictionary, which stands for the letter D actually. So, what is this has got anything to do with your theory of happiness? Let me take few seconds to cover that. See, the system of feeling happy or expressing your happiness is largely coming from the attitude and the choices that we make, the beliefs that we have. Hence, for the theory of happiness to be appreciated, it is very important to understand how this ABCD mechanism is working. So, going forward in the next session, I would like to explain to you how these attitudes are formed. So, that's the most important topic that we would like to take as the next item in our discussion. Thank you very much. I hope that seeing all these videos are gradually helping you as a building block to appreciate the mechanism of happiness, which will lead you to a great amount of freedom and expression of yourself more beautifully in your life. God bless you. Thank you very much for listening to me and look forward to see you in future videos. God bless you. Take care. Have a nice day.